Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible? Yes. What have we discussed till now? Anyone? What all we have discussed? Tell me, please. We were discussing excretory system. Any doubt in that? Is there any doubt in excretory system? No. Anybody else having doubt? We'll be starting in next 1 minute. Yes. Let's see. Am I audible now? Pranav, can you hear me? Yes. Let's see. We were discussing excretory system. Now some part of endocrine system we are going to discuss now. Let's see. Endocrine system. What do you think? What is endocrine system? Do you people know about the word coordination? Do you people know about the word coordination? Tell me. What is coordination? Yes. What is coordination? Let's see. When we run your skeletal system is used. Muscles are used. Yes or no? But you will observe this thing that even your heart rate increases, your respiratory rate increases. Yes or no? Everyone? Heart rate, respiratory rate, everything is going to increase. And when we stop, what happens? When we stop, heart rate comes to normal and respiratory rate also comes to normal. Do you people observe these things? Do you people observe these things? Say yes or no. We are going to observe these things, no? Yes. Why it is so? It is because of coordination. Because of coordination. So what is the meaning of coordination? It is the process. By which two or more. Agreed? It is the process by which two or more organ or organ system interact to complement function of each other. Do you people agree? Do you people agree? Saswat, I am explaining endocrine system. Agreed? Here is it. I have just explained coordination part in that. Getting my point? Do you know what all systems are there for coordination in your body? We have nervous system, and endocrine system in place for coordination. Coordination. Everyone, any doubt in that? Yes. The thing is, this will be known as neural control and coordination, and this is known as chemical control and coordination. Everyone, have you any doubt in this? Do you people have any doubt in this? No? See, you will ask me, sir, is there any special significance to, you can say, for these two systems? Yes. This is point to point. Only going to supply those cells which are, you can say, which is having the nerve supply. It is like electricity, you can say, connection of your house, and it is diffuse. Agreed? Diffuse means, I will say, hormones are released into blood and any cell having receptor can use the hormone. Actually, try to understand my point. Here is the hormone, and one cell is there. This is the receptor. Once this hormone will join the receptor to form hormone receptor complex, in that case only, what is going to happen? Physiological effect will be there. So this is there. What are other difference? See, the neural coordination is, you can say, onset is fast, it happens quick, and short lasting. And here the onset is slow and long lasting. Yes or no? These are the major differences that are there. So you people are going to read these topics under coordination, everyone. Now let's see, what will I say over here? Endocrine system. Endocrine system. This system is going to have two things. This system is going to have two things. Let's see, it is consisting of endocrine gland and hormones. Endocrine gland and hormones. Do you people have any problem in this? No issues. Let's see. Gland is there, na? Gland is having two parts actually. In general, let's see. This is a gland. This is the secretory part of gland, and this is the duct. Duct simply means a pipe. Duct simply means a pipe. Agreed, everyone? So endocrine glands are ductless gland. Only secretory part is there. Okay. And its secretion is directly poured into blood. So where the secretion of endocrine gland is going to go? Where the secretion of endocrine gland is going to go? It will be poured into blood, and the hormone will circulate through blood only. So this is endocrine gland. You people can see. What is the definition of hormone? Can you people tell me? What is the definition of, you can say, hormone? Anyone? any one of you, do you people know definition of a stimulator? Pranav is saying a stimulator. See, Pranav, actually hormone is not always a stimulator. It can stimulate the function, and it can, you can say, decrease the function also. Agreed, everyone? Let's see. What will I say over here? Hormones are known nutrient chemicals secreted in a small amount, non-nutrient chemicals which is secreted in a small amount. Yes or no? First thing, it is non-nutrient chemical. It is not going to provide any kind of nutrition to your body. Everyone agree? Means you are not going to get any energy or something like that from a hormone. Everyone, is there any doubt? No issues. Secreted in a small amount and act as intercellular messengers. Means it brings information from one cell and supply it to another cell. Yes or no? Everyone? Yes. So this is there. If I will talk about hormones, I will talk over here the classification of hormone. Of hormone. What is the classification of hormone? Please tell me, dear. Based on chemical nature, hormones are of following types. What do you think? One is peptide, polypeptide, and protein. Rather, I will say or protein hormones. Second is amino acid derivative. Yes or no? Have you heard about these things, dear? Because I want to make one thing very clear over here. It is amino acid derivative. It can be iodothyronines, and it is steroid in nature. A steroid is a lipid. Do you people understand? You can say difference, sir, but aren't these? No, they are non-nutrient thing. They are not going to be metabolized to produce any kind of energy to your body. They are non-nutrient chemicals. Everyone, do you have any doubt in this? Yes, let's see. steroid hormone. Are you people aware about protein, lipid, carbohydrate and all? So if I am going to write, yes, if I am going to write, all the hormones are proteins. What will you say? Is this a statement correct or not? This is a wrong statement, because I have told you people four classes that is there. What are there in the steroid hormone? Testosterone. Second one is estrogen. Third one is hormones of adrenal cortex region. Hormones of adrenal cortex region. Everyone, I will let you know. In iodothyronine, T3 and T4 is there. Let's see. T3 is there. T4 is there. What is T3? T3 is triiodothyronines, and it is tetraiodothyronines. Only T4 is known as thyroxine. Okay, you can ask me, sir, which kind of, how this is iodothyronine, you can say thyronines. Actually, one amino acid is tyrosine. Do you know about this amino acid? Have you heard the name earlier at any place? Tyrosine. With that, iodine going to be joined to form iodothyronines. So can you people see over here, for secretion of iodothyronine, iodine is needed? Yes or no? Is it needed or not? Yes. Everyone, in amino acid derivative, there are two. One is epinephrine. Epinephrine is there. And in you can say polypeptide hormone, hormones of pituitary gland, hypothalamus, etc. Everyone. Do you people agree with this? Anybody having doubt in these things? Now, what all glands are there? Let's see that. What all glands are there? Yes, tell me, dear.
Could you scroll up, sir?
What? Scroll up? Yes. Done. Now, what all you can say endocrine glands are there, you people can observe a bit. there are three in the head. Let's see. Following are the endocrine gland. Are the endocrine glands. First is pituitary gland. Second is pineal gland. Third is hypothalamus. Fourth is thyroid gland. Fifth is parathyroid gland. Sixth is thymus, pancreas, adrenal gland, and ninth is gonads. In gonads, ovary is there and testis is there. Yes or no? The question is, which of the following is not a endocrine gland, is not a endocrine gland? One is pituitary gland. Second is pineal gland. Third is thymus gland, and fourth is salivary gland. What do you think, dear? It is salivary gland, yes, of course. Then what kind of gland is salivary gland? Tell me. What kind of gland is salivary gland? Anybody? Exocrine. So, salivary gland is a exocrine gland. This is salivary gland. One thing. The next thing is, there are few mixed gland also. Pancreas is a mixed gland. Why? It is having, pancreas having endocrine as well as exocrine, both the parts are there. See, this is a typical exocrine gland. Gland with duct. Okay? Exocrine glands are gland with duct. Is there any doubt? Tell me, dear, is there any doubt? No? Understood? Clear till now? Just a minute. Yes, everyone. tell me if you have any doubt. No? No. I will be talking about some of the glands over here. Let's see. Just give me a minute. I am going to show you a diagram over here. What is the connection between endocrine gland, that is pituitary, and hypothalamus? Do you people know? Let's see. I will talk about hypothalamus and pituitary gland. Let's see. Hypothalamus and pituitary gland. Yes or no? Hypothalamus and pituitary gland. Let's see. What happens? This is your hypothalamus. This is your hypothalamus. Everyone, this is infundibulum. It connects hypothalamus to pituitary. Agreed, everyone? Any doubt? What is infundibulum? Can you people explain? It is the connection of hypothalamus to pituitary. Agreed? Now, this is pars distalis or anterior lobe of pars nervosa or posterior and this one is the red one is pars intermedia or intermediate lobe of pituitary or middle lobe of pituitary or middle lobe of pituitary. Agreed, everyone? Everyone? Any doubt? Tell me, dear. So how many lobes are there? Yes, of course. You will. Everyone, any doubt? Agreed? See, now there is one blood vessel, you see,
These are the neurons present in hypothalamus. Anybody having any doubt in this? Please see this diagram. You people have to pay attention over here. See over here. Do you know? Do you people know the hypothalamus is going to control secretion of anterior pituitary and posterior? You can see over here. Hypothalamus is going to release a hormone over here. This hormone will come inside this blood vessel, will travel through this, and will leave from here. And from here, the hormone that is flowing from hypothalamus to pituitary comes. Do you know what this structure is known as? This structure is known as hypophyseal portal vein. Can I say it connects? Can I say it connects hypothalamus to anterior pituitary? Can I say that? The hormone which is flowing from hypothalamus is going to go to pituitary, anterior pituitary via which vein? Hypophyseal portal vein. Yes or no? Everyone? Any doubt in this? Tell me here. If I will say over here, that hypothalamus is connected to anterior lobe by hypophyseal portal vein. Do you people have any problem? Say yes or no. Do you people agree with this statement of mine? Agreed or not? Tell me, dear. Let's see. Now, hormone released by pituitary gland. By pituitary gland. Let's see what is going to be there. I will talk about anterior lobe of pituitary middle lobe of pituitary and posterior lobe of pituitary. Everyone, anterior lobe of pituitary, let's see what all hormones are going to be released. Growth hormone. LH, luteinizing hormone. TSH, it is thyroid stimulating hormone. One is FSH, follicle stimulating hormone. Next one is ACTH, adrenocorticotropic hormone, and PRN, prolactin. Have you heard about these hormones? It is responsible for growth of the body, responsible for growth of body. Growth of the body. It is responsible for ovulation. It acts on thyroid gland. It is responsible for development of follicle inside female ovary. Done. It act on adrenal gland. And PRL, prolactin, is responsible for what? Synthesis of milk inside mammary gland. What? Synthesis of milk inside mammary gland. Everyone. Milk means milk releasing hormone. Bolo. Tell me, dear. Any doubt in this? Tell me, do you people agree with all these things? May not milk releasing. I have made a mistake over here. It is milk synthesizing rather. It brings about synthesis of milk, not releasing. For release, some other hormone is there. One is MSH. It is melanocyte stimulating hormone. Tell me, just give me a minute. Yes, dear. Melanocytes are cells present inside your skin. Melanocytes are cells present in your skin, and it synthesizes a pigment, melanin, and this melanin is going to give your skin a dark complexion. Getting my point? In Negroes and blacks, more melanin pigment activity is there. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. More melanin pigment activity is there. Agreed? So it acts on melanocytes and stimulates synthesis of melanin by melanocytes. Now, I will talk about posterior lobe of pituitary. Over here, there are two hormones. One is oxytocin and another is vasopressin. Oxytocin is there for contraction of a smooth muscle, having two roles. One is during childbirth, which is known as parturition. It brings about contraction of uterus. Another is milk releasing hormone. So you see, oxytocin is responsible for two functions. Agreed, everyone? So please understand the difference between milk synthesizing hormone and milk releasing hormone. Vasopressin is known as antidiuretic hormone. What? Neuretic hormone. Let's see. What is diuresis? It is loss of excess water through urine. It is loss of excess water through urine. So that means antidiuretic. What will be the function then? It is against the diuresis, means it conserves water. Now, question is there, during winters or after drinking alcohol, frequent urination is there because of which hormone? First is growth hormone, second is follicle stimulating hormone, third is ADH, and fourth is none of these. What do you people think? What should be the answer? It is due to ADH. The hormone involved, I will say, ADH. What happens after drinking or in winters? Secretion of ADH is going to decrease. If it is there, it is, you can say, conserves water. That means less frequent urination will be there. And if it is not there, more and more water will be lost through the body. In that case, what will happen? More urination will be there. So it is there. In absence of ADH or hyposecretion of ADH, a disease is going to be there that is known as diabetes, insipidus. Diabetes insipidus. So, one is diabetes mellitus, that is due to insulin. Yes, vasopressin is only known as ADH. No issues in that. Its another name is antidiuretic hormone, that is ATH. Everyone, do you people have any, you can say, doubt in that? Growth hormone, hypersecretion will cause zygentism, and hyposecretion will cause dwarfism. The hyposecretion means less secretion, hypersecretion means more secretion that is there. Yes, let's see, dear. Some more hormones are there. I will let you know. See, one is pineal gland. It is going to secrete melatonin. This is a hormone which is going to maintain your circadian rhythm. It is the normal daylight. Yes. Just a minute. Just a minute. Let's see. Circadian rhythm is due to melatonin. One thing you people can hear, jet lag. Do you people know what is jet lag? Do you people know what is jet lag? Tell me, dear. What is jet lag? Am I audible to you? Yes. Yes, when we travel far, in that case. So melatonin is responsible for that. Let's see. One thing is there. Circadian rhythm, jet lag is there. Normal diurnal rhythm is maintained by this. Now, one significant thing that you people should remember, it is responsible for fair complexion. So can I say MSH and melatonin act against each other? Can I say that? I will say MSH and melatonin act against each other. Can I say that? Tell me here. And when a hormone acts against each other, that hormone is known as antagonistic hormone. Yes or no? So are MSH and melatonin are antagonistic hormone? Is it there or not? MSH and melatonin are antagonistic hormones or not? Tell me that. Tell me, dear. Is it like that? Let's see. Sorry. Yes. Aditya is saying yes. So any hormone that is acting against each other is known as just give me a minute. My headphone is getting down. Am I audible now? I have changed the headphone. That is why I am asking. Am I audible to you people? Yes. Let's see. Melatonin is there. Now thyroid is there. No issues. Thyroid is going to secrete a hormone known as thyroxine. Or this is only T4. T3 is also there. Another hormone that is secreted by thyroid itself is calcitonin. By parathyroid gland, one hormone is secreted known as PTH or parathormone. Okay. Pancreas is going to secrete, it is having a group of cells that is known as islets of Langerhans. This is going to have principally two types of cell. One is alpha cell, one is beta cell. Principally, I am saying, otherwise four types of cells are there. One hormone is glucagon. Another is insulin. So insulin is secreted by beta cells. Yes or no? Everyone? Glucagon will increase the blood glucose level. And it will decrease the blood glucose level. Agreed, everyone? Yes, Aditya is saying yes. Have you any doubt? The hormone that is going to increase the blood glucose level will be known as hyperglycemic hormone. And here, the hormone which is going to secrete blood, you can say that is going to decrease blood glucose level, is going to known as hypoglycemic hormone. Everyone, do you people have any doubt in this? No. Yes. Great. Let's see. One is adrenal gland. I am writing over here. Adrenal gland is going to have two parts. The outer part is known as First the inner part and then the outer part. The inner part is going to be known as adrenal medulla. And the outer part will be known as adrenal cortex. Agreed? Adrenal cortex. Adrenal cortex is going to secrete three kind of hormones. One is mineralocorticoids. Everyone. One is glucocorticoids. Another is sex corticoids. Adrenal medulla is going to secrete two hormones that is known as adrenaline and noradrenaline. That is known as adrenaline and noradrenaline. Or epinephrine and norepinephrine is also used for the same hormone. Glycemic, glucose, hypoglycemic. Hypo means less, glycemic in blood glucose, you can say. Amic word is used for blood, gly for glucose, and hyper for more. Hypo for less, gly for glucose, amic is there for blood. So high blood glucose is hyperglycemic condition. Low blood glucose is known as hypoglycemic condition. You know, the chief mineralocorticoid in your body is aldosterone. And the chief glucocorticoid in your body is cortisol. It is sex corticoid is estrogen and progesterone only. See over here. Now we will talk about gonads. Ovary is going to secrete estrogen, progesterone. One hormone is relaxin. What happens during childbirth? It dilates birth canal. Testis is there. Testosterone is the chief hormone that is going to be secreted. And you know, what is the group? Testis belong to a group of hormone known as androgens. Androgen is the group of hormone and testosterone is the individual hormone. Yes or no, everyone? Do you people have any doubt in that? Agreed, everyone? Everyone, do you people agree with this? Say yes or no, please. Yes, after this, you people should go and read your book very nicely. Okay, in that much time, what we can discuss and what are important that we have done already. Okay, you read your, you can say textbook and ask me doubts from, you can say whatever section you want to ask. Okay, you people can send your doubts in between the class also, means every Sunday class is there. So you can send the doubts, I will solve. Tell me, aldosterone do? Yes, a great question. See over here. I have told you people that kidney partner, that kidney part na? Let's see. Just give me a minute. Here is it. Here is it. Let's see. Let's see. This is your distal convoluted tubule now. Let's see. From here only, the aldosterone will work, will take out Na plus, and with that, water will also come. Means it helps in retention of Na plus inside blood. It helps in retention of Na plus inside blood. It is absorbing Na plus from urine. You can say the thing that is going to be there and which will form the urine. Yes or no? From distal convoluted tubule, it will reabsorb Na plus. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Any doubt? Is it clear now? Aditya? Yes. So if you have asked me a question, I'm going to tell you something more. Let's see. Aldosterone is there. What it will do? It will increase Na plus. So in blood, along with Na plus, water will also come. So blood pressure will increase. And it leads to decrease K plus in blood, because secretion of K plus is there. It will secrete K plus outside. Yes or no? So if somebody have hyper secretion of aldosterone, what do you think? What will happen? What do you think? What will happen? Tell me, dear. In that case, in the low potassium. Low potassium, yes. Potassium level will decrease in blood because it is removing it from the blood. Agreed? Everyone, if you people have any doubt in this segment, you can ask. You people can take 2 minutes for that. You people can take 2 minutes. You can rethink once. Read your, you can say, textbook very nicely. Questions are going to be there from that book only. And apart from that, you can see my notes also. That is going to help you people. Now, one is nervous system. One is, next was nervous control and coordination. So I will talk about nervous system. I will talk about human nervous system. Do you know what is there? Human nervous system is divided into two parts. One is central nervous system. Which is CNS. Another is peripheral nervous system, which is PNS. Agreed? Actually, what happens? The basic idea is, this is your brain. This is your spinal cord. This is brain. This is a spinal cord. And this is organ. Getting my point? From CNS, some nerves will originate that will connect a spinal cord to organ, or brain from the organ. Yes or no? That is, so see over here, brain and just give me a minute. Let's see over here. Dear, here, brain is there and a spinal cord is there. Two things are there. The nerve originating from, this is the nerve originating from the brain, that is known as cranial nerves. What is there? Peripheral nervous system consists of 12 pairs of cranial nerves and 31 pairs of spinal nerves. You people can see the nerve originating directly from the brain is the, that can also supply the, that can also supply the organ. And a nerve that is coming from the spinal cord, that is also going to supply the organ. So nerve originating from brain is known as cranial nerves. Okay? And the nerve originating from the spinal cord is known as spinal nerves. Everyone, do you people agree? Now, peripheral nervous system is divided into two divisions. Peripheral nervous system is divided into two divisions. One is somatic nervous system. Another is autonomic nervous system. Tell me, dear. What is somatic nervous system? Do you know? You people have two types of muscles also. One is voluntary muscle and one is involuntary muscle. Somatic nervous system is going to supply skeletal muscle. Means this is under control of your will. And here, autonomic nervous system, it supplies the visceral organ. Do you people know what is visceral organs? Like, your heart is beating. Can you control that as per your will? If you want to stop, can you stop your heart? No. That is autonomic. Okay? Your GIT is working, gastrointestinal tract is working. What do you think? Is that under your control? No. Everything of that kind will fall under autonomic nervous system. Do you know? Now, autonomic nervous system is there, no? It is having, autonomic nervous system is there. It is having two divisions. One is somatic sympathetic nervous system. Nervous system, and one is parasympathetic nervous system. Do you know what is sympathetic nervous system? It is going to work in emergency. When your body is facing, you can say facing some kind of emergency. And it is going to be there under normal condition. It is going to be there in the normal condition. Agreed, everyone? Now, what kind of emergency? Like, imagine a condition. Imagine a condition. A naja naja is there behind you. Do you people know what is naja naja? What is naja naja? Tell me, what is Naja Naja? That is cobra. Okay, that is cobra. A snake is there. If that snake is behind you, what all things will happen to you? That will fall under sympathetic nervous system. Let's see. When a snake is behind you, what will happen with heart rate or some fearful? Yes, Shraddha is saying increased heart rate. What will happen to respiratory rate? What will happen to respiratory rate? Yes, Raghav is saying, sir, it will increase. Yes, you are right, Raghav. Increase respiratory rate. Try to understand, when a naza is behind you, will you people think that I am going to eat something, then after that I will run? I told if some, no, you surely you are not going to do that. Or you are thinking I will have Maggie after that? No, immediate action. So I will not eat. So action of GIT, gastrointestinal tract, will decrease all the time. Will decrease all the time. Okay. What all actions are there? Please tell me, dear. What all actions are there? Please tell me, dear. See over here. What all is going to happen? Please see over here. Yes. Decrease means secretion of saliva. What do you think? Should it increase or decrease? Secretion of gastric glands. Should it increase or decrease? Peristalsis. Should it increase or decrease? Everything should decrease. So if they will ask, you can think the situation and you can answer. Okay, now, blood supply to skeletal muscle. What do you people think? What should happen? Blood supply to skeletal muscle. What should happen? It should increase. Yes. Blood supply to skeletal muscle should increase. Blood supply to brain. And all the opposite action will take place in parasympathetic nervous system. All the opposite action will take place in parasympathetic nervous system. Yes or no? Heart rate decrease. Respiratory rate decrease. Action of GIT will increase. Now we'll talk about neurons. Rather, we'll talk about nervous tissue. We'll talk about nervous tissue. Do you people know what is the origin of nervous tissue? There are two kind of cells that are there. One is neuron, another is neuroglial cells. One is neuron, another is neuroglial cells. Yes or no? Neuron is actually, it can detect, can conduct and transmit the impulse. Another is neuroglial cells. They are supporting in action. Supporting cells. Agreed? Straight away, I will talk about neuron. Let's see what is there in the neuron. Everyone. Nervous tissue. Neuron. How many parts are there in the neuron? See, many kind of supports are there. If you have asked, I'm going to explain it to you. Aditi is saying what kind of support is needed, sir. Let's see. Neuroglial cells is there, no? It is of many types. Astrocytes, oligodendrocyte, Schwann cell. See, like oligodendrocyte is going to form myelin sheath in central nervous system. Schwann cell is going to form, myelin sheath in peripheral nervous system. Microglial cells are there, na? They come from blood. They are phagocytic cells. That means that it is not going to let anything to infect. It will not let anything to infect the brain, any bacteria or something. Yes or no? Done? Aditya? Got it? Yes. Let's see. Neurons having three parts. Chiefly. And they are dendrite, cell body, and axon. What are dendrites? Dendrites are going to carry information towards the cell body. Cell body is the main site of processing the information. And what axons will do? Axons will conduct impulse away from the cell body. Do you people agree with me? Tell me. Tell me, dear. Any doubt in this? Yes. Now, you can see in axon, do you know? This black one is Schwann cell. Okay, this is Schwann cell. And around Schwann cell, it is wrapped by myelin sheath. Yes or no? It is wrapped by myelin sheath. Everyone? Yes. See, at places myelin sheath is absent. That is known as node of Ranvier. Getting my point? Myelin sheath is absent. It will come over here. This is known as axon terminal. axon terminal, and that is going to end in a swollen end that is known as synaptic nerve. That is known as synaptic nerve. It contains synaptic vesicle in which neurotransmitters are there. Yes or no? In which neurotransmitters are there? You can ask me, sir, what is the role of neurotransmitter? Later on, I am going to discuss with you people synapse. At that place, I will let you know the function of neurotransmitters. Everyone, do you people agree? Now, I will be talking about types of neurons. Types of neurons. Yes or no? Tell me. Types of neuron. On the basis of direction of conduction, there are two types of neurons that are there. One is known as afferent fiber and one is known as efferent fiber. One is known as afferent fiber. One is known as efferent fiber. Agreed? Now see, afferent. It is carrying impulse towards central nervous system. Means from the organ, it is taking the impulse towards brain or spinal cord. It is also known as sensory fibers. Efferent means it is going to come or it is going to take impulse away from CNS to the muscle. So this is known as motor fibers also. Do you people agree? Do you people agree? Afferent and efferent fiber. Any doubt in that? Is it clear? Tell me, dear. Everyone. I think you people should reply. Okay, all of you are sitting in the class, so please interact. See over here. Now, one is fiber. It is single neuron. On that basis, nerve is of three types. One is sensory, one is motor, and one is mixed. Sensory is there, one fiber nerve, which is having only afferent fibers in one direction, wrapped into a sheath. Mixed nerve having fibers which is conducting in both the direction, sensory as well as motor. And motor nerve only have fiber that is supplying from CNS to the organ. Yes or no, everyone? Everyone, tell me, dear. On the basis of presence or absence of myelin sheath. On the basis of presence or absence of myelin sheath. One is myelinated neurons. Another is unmyelinated or non-myelinated neurons. One is myelinated neurons. One is non-myelinated or unmyelinated neurons. See over here. Myelinated neurons are there in which Schwann cells secrete myelin sheath around the axon. A non-myelinated is there. Schwann cells do not secrete myelin sheath around axon. Schwann cells are present in both the cases. Schwann cells are present in both the cases. Now, wherever myelin sheath is there, at that place axon appears whitish. Axon appears whitish. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Wherever myelin sheath is there, at that place, axon is whitish. Yes or no? You got tired?
Are you people tired now? Are you done? Okay. Let's see. Myelin sheath is there, which is around the axon. Schwann cells are present in both the cases, and wherever myelin sheath is there, it appears whitish. Now, do you people know about gray matter and white matter? See, this is cerebral cortex. Of your brain. See how cells are arranged. Like this, now. In the outer area, cell bodies are concentrated. So that is made up of gray matter. Why gray matter? And why white matter? Because axons are there in the inner area. And wherever myelinated axons are there, what will be the color? Wherever myelinated axons are there, yes. So white is the outer part of brain is known as, you can say, made up of gray matter, and inner part is known made up of white matter. Do you people agree with this? Agreed? Just a minute. Yes, everyone. Aditya is saying, sir, can you repeat? The thing is there, in the outer part, cell body is there, and in the inner part, axon is there. So cell body is going to make things gray. And wherever axon is there, what kind of matter will be there? Tell me. Wherever axon will be there, Adit, which is myelinated, what is the color? White with myelin. So you see, inner part having axon with myelin sheath. So color of inner part will be white. And you can say outer part will be gray. Everyone agreed? So can I say in the brain the outer part is made up of gray matter and the inner part is made up of white matter? Can I say that? Tell me, dear. Can I say that? And opposite is true for a spinal cord. A spinal cord having inner part made up of gray matter and outer part made up of white matter. You people can think upon this for a minute. Be very sure about this. Be very sure about this. Everyone. Everyone. Yes, got it. Now, have you people read about this formula? resistance is equal to rho L upon A. Do you people know about this formula? These formulas? Yes. The thing is there, the neuron is going to follow the same. Rate of conduction between faster in shorter and thicker neuron. In thicker neuron, resistance will be less, so more SPD conduction will be there, and in the shorter neuron also. Understood? Do you people agree with this point of mine? Everyone? Yes, clear. Let's see. On the basis of cell processes, it is unipolar. One cell body is there and one axon is there. That's all. Bipolar, this one. One dendrite, one cell body, and one axon. Multipolar, that I have made over here. This is many dendrite and one axon. And one is pseudo unipolar. It comes like this as one divided into two. It looks like it is unipolar, but actually it is bipolar. So this is there. Agreed? It is there in the retina of eye. It is there in the cerebral cortex. It is there in the dorsal root of a spinal cord. Later on, we will see that. Unipolar, it is there in the invertebrates and non-chordates actually. Agreed, everyone? Any doubt in this? Yes. Let's see. We'll talk about nerve conduction. We'll talk about nerve conduction. Let's see. What do you people know about the nerve conduction? Can you suggest me something? See, this is the diagram of axon. Actually, what is conduction? Meaning of conduction? Everyone. What is the meaning of conduction? How impulse travel along axon? How impulse travel along axon? Electric signal jump downwards the axon, jumping from one node to another. If it is jumping from one node to another, it will become saltatory conduction, dear. It will become saltatory conduction. Yes or no? Saltatory conduction. Yes or no? Later on, we will see. I am going to talk about nerve conduction over here. Nerve conduction over here. Let's see. I want to make few points over here that is logical. From the evolution point of view, where the cell originated? Where the cell originated? In which part? Is it in the water or in on land? Wherever it is. In water. Raghav is saying water. Raghav, which kind of water? Is it ocean or fresh water bodies like river and all? Is it ocean or not? Raghav? Salt water. Aditya is saying salt water. So from that point of time only, our cells are adapted that outside it, as you have called salt water. What is there in the salt water? NaCl is there, no? Yes. So from that point of time only, our cells are adapted like outside the cell, always Na plus concentration is on the higher side. Na plus concentration is on the higher side. Yes or no? Everyone. Yes. Same is there in our exon also. You see, outside Na plus concentration is 141 milliequivalent per liter. K plus concentration is more 4 milliequivalent per liter. Even if you do not remember it exactly, no issues issue is there. Agreed? No issue is there. Everyone. Inside Na plus concentration is 14 milliequivalent per liter, and K plus concentration is 139 milliequivalent per liter. Any doubt? Any doubt, dear? Clear. What I want to make, you can say the point I want to make over here. The point is outside Na plus is more, and not slight difference is there. Rather, it is many a times more than the inside, around 10 times more. Yes or no? And inside K plus is more. Everyone. Yes. Only Raghav is saying yes. Anybody else having doubt? I told, Hariharan is also saying yes. I told outside Na plus concentration is more and inside K plus concentration is more. Yes or no? Everyone, rest can answer also. Others should also try, dear. Have you any doubt in this? Have you any doubt in this? Tell me. Yes. Let's see over here. Now, in the membrane, I have different types of channel and pumps. What is the difference between channel and pump? What is a channel and a pump? See, channel is because you people know that your cell membrane is like this. Same is the case with exolemma also. It is like this, na? A protein should cross the cell membrane like this. Agreed, everyone? Agreed, everyone? This protein is going to form channel. Channel is there. Channel allows movement according to concentration gradient, means higher concentration to lower concentration. Like this is voltage gated Na plus channel. Whenever it will open, Na plus will move from outside to inside. It cannot move from inside to outside, because if you are moving anything against the concentration gradient, what you will require? You will require ATP. Yes or no? And that is the function of a pump. Yes or no? Everyone? Yes. Raghav is saying yes. Let's see. So this is voltage gated sodium channel, voltage gated potassium channel, and sodium potassium pump is there. And there are some leaky channel, which is always open. Which is always open. Agreed? You people are clear with this concept? Now, there is a concept of threshold potential. What is threshold potential? Try to understand my point. You have to open a gate. You have to open a gate. You require some minimum force to open that gate. Yes or no? Like in your house, one heavy gate is there. Gate is very heavy. And you have to open that gate. If you will try to open that gate with the help of a finger, will you able to do that? Gate is heavy. No. you will increase the force. The minimum force at which you are going to open, you will be able to open that gate, that force will be known as threshold. Yes or no? The minimum force. Yes or no? Everyone? Yes. What will happen? Threshold, you people understood? If you will apply a force which is lesser than threshold, will you be able to open that gate? Lesser than threshold? No. And what if you are going to apply a force greater than threshold? It will open. So I will like to define over here, threshold potential is the minimum potential required for conduction of impulse. Means less than this cannot be conducted. So the sub-threshold stimulus or potential cannot be conducted. Sub-threshold potential or stimulus cannot be completed. You can say cannot be conducted. Yes or no? Agreed? Sub-threshold, less than threshold. Same thing. Everyone? Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Yes. So what will happen, you see, when a threshold stimulus arrived, yes or no, that will lead to opening of voltage-gated sodium channel. Everyone will see. You see, here the channel is closed, and here you can see it is open. It is open. It was like this earlier. Now it is like this. So what will happen? If this channel is open, sodium will flow in, yes or no? When a threshold stimulus arrived, that leads to inflow of sodium inside the exoplasm, yes or no? Exoplasm is the cytoplasm present in exon, isn't it? Tell me. Tell me, dear. Yes, yes, of course. Now, see over here what I want to tell you. Sodium has flown in, that is known as influx of sodium ion. Arrival of threshold potential, opening of sodium channel, and that lead to influx of sodium ion. Yes or no, everyone? Threshold stimulus has arrived, opened this gate, that lead to movement of sodium from outside to inside, from higher concentration to lower concentration. Yes or no? Everyone? Yes, understood. Now, important thing, you see, earlier outside was positive, inside was negative. Earlier outside was positive, inside was negative. Here see, what is the difference that you people can see from here to here? Lots of sodium ion is there that has made things positive over here. Yes or no? Due to influx of sodium ion, what happened over here? Things becomes positive. It became positive. Yes or no? Everyone? Understood or not? Yes. And do you people know that current flows from positive to negative charge? Do you people know? Yes. Tell me. Do you people know current flows from? Yes. So you see, here the conduction has started. Now it will move. It will open sodium channel, present ahead, and conduction will take place in this way only. Now you try to understand my point. So how conduction has started? How conduction has started? It has started due to influx of what? Sodium ion. Everyone? It has started? Yes, influx of sodium. Now you see, the problem is the opening of voltage-gated sodium channel is short-lived. Short-lived. No issues? Here is short-lived. Now you see the channel got closed. The channel got closed. Here you can see sodium channel is closed now. Yes or no? Everyone, the sodium channel has opened. Lots of sodium came in. Now the channel is closed. What do you think? Sodium got trapped inside. Yes or no? Sodium got trapped inside? Yes, of course, it got trapped inside. Now, it will repel the potassium. Let's see. This is your potassium channel. This is your potassium channel. Agreed, everyone? Here is the potassium channel. Try to understand my point, what I am to tell you. Here, sodium is repelling the potassium. Now, potassium moved outside. Yes or no? Due to opening of potassium channel. Everyone? Yes. Now you see, if you will remove positive charge, which were present over here, positive charge which were present over here, now it became negative again. Agreed? Now it became negative again. Everyone? Here it is negative, you can see. Here it became negative. Like what had happened, what is there, you can say initially. So what happened? First influx of sodium ion, then movement of potassium ion outside, that is efflux of potassium ion. Yes or no? Can you people see any difference between this condition and this condition?
Can you see any difference that is there? Can you see any difference? Tell me, dear. Any difference is there?
Yes. More sodium inside and more potassium outside, and that is not at all a normal condition. Then comes sodium potassium pump into play. What will happen? Try to understand my point. Now sodium potassium pump will take 3Na plus outside and 2K plus inside. 2K plus inside to reach the resting state. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Everyone? Yes. So how conduction has started? Due to influx of sodium ion. Then efflux of potassium ion is there. And then again sodium potassium pump will come into play to reach the resting state, yes or no? Everyone, are you people clear about the definition of threshold potential? Definition of threshold potential? Yes. Now I'm going to tell you people few more definitions. See over here. Here, inside is negative and outside is positive. How can I differentiate or different? Do you people know about potentiometer and all? Potentiometer. What we do with that? We measure the potential difference, something like that, na? Yes. What have I done? I have taken a very delicate. These are there in the labs. I have inserted an electrode over here and the electrode over here. Electrode over here and electrode over here. And I have connected it to the potentiometer. Will I be able to, you can say, measure the difference in potential between inside and outside? Can I do that? Hariharan is saying yes. Shraddha, is it like that? If I will insert a electrode over here and one on the surface and connect them with potentiometer, will I be able to differentiate between, you can say, or we will be able to find out potential difference between inside and outside of the membrane? Agreed? Yes. And this time conduction is taking place or not? Conduction is taking place or not? Is it taking place? No, it is not taking place. So, potential inside minus potential outside at resting state is known as resting membrane potential. Yes or no? Is known as resting membrane potential, and it is minus 70 millivolt to minus 90 millivolt. And when this difference, potential inside minus potential outside, we will do when conduction is going on. When conduction is going on, that will be known as action potential. So you people should be clear with the definition of threshold potential, definition of resting membrane potential, and the definition of action potential that is there. Yes or no? Agreed, everyone? Do you people have any doubt in these three points? Tell me. Agreed? Yes. We'll meet you people in the next class. Okay. Goodbye.